The last time John Kerry was in Egypt campaigning for the country's first democratic presidential election was in full swing. Back then, he assured Egyptians the U.S. didn't have a favorite candidate. But 9 months later, some opposition figures are not welcoming the Secretary of State. They say Washington is too close to the ruling Muslim Brotherhood.
We do not trust American foreign policy because it's all about imposing a certain vision or group for its own stability. All they care about is Israel's security. If anyone guarantees that, like President Morsi, they're willing to cooperate with them, and that's very dangerous.
After demonstrating against the president for months, some opposition parties have announced they'll be boycotting upcoming parliamentary elections. An apparent plea by the State Department to reconsider has led to calls for protests against Kerry's visit. Present on their minds, fresh revelations that the police imported $2.5 million worth of U.S.-made tear gas at the height of economic hardships. The controversial deal is one of the issues activists intend to raise with Kerry.
I think the issues that civil society organizations want to raise with the United States government is the nature of their support to the current Egyptian government and the extent to which they condone or acquiesce in issues like ongoing police brutality, impunity for that.
Despite violent protests outside the U.S. Embassy in Cairo last September, the Obama administration has fought to keep Egypt's $1.6 billion aid package intact. Most of the aid goes to the military, which just got a brand new consignment of 20 F-16 fighter jets. John Kerry insists that U.S. aid to Egypt must continue or the country will slip to chaos. But critics say that most of the aid is sent to ensure stability by safeguarding the peace treaty with Israel, something that may have the opposite effect if Egyptian democracy is stifled in the long run. Rawia Ragah, Al Jazeera, Cairo.